MAC addresses are hugely important in Ethernet network communication. MAC addresses are used to identify devices. Switches need them to do their job, which of course is switching. MAC addresses are used to implement cybersecurity measures, and they're also exploited by attackers too. Now, this video is part of a mini series designed to help you master MAC addresses for network cybersecurity. We'll begin by learning the fundamentals to give you a solid foundation to build your knowledge as you progress. Now, before we begin, please remember, if you find the video helpful, help the video by giving it a like, share it, leave a comment below because I'm always interested to hear your comments, and don't forget to subscribe to the IT Taster channel for more content. So with that said, let's get into the video. All Ethernet networks use MAC addresses to communicate. That's how important they are. Now, MAC addresses identify physical devices on an Ethernet network by their individual network interface cards, their NICs. MAC addresses are used for NIC-to-NIC communication within the same network segment. Now, you might be thinking, what about IP addresses? Well, yes, they have an important role too in the communication process, and we'll talk about that later on. But getting to grips with MAC addresses first is something that will really pay off. Now, each network device has a network interface card, and that will be typically connected by either an Ethernet cable or Wi-Fi. Now, all network cards are shipped with a special unique address hard-coded into them by the manufacturer, and that of course is the MAC address. Now, MAC addresses are also sometimes referred to as either a physical address or a burned-in address, and that's because it's a permanent fixed address stored in a ROM chip. It can be thought of as a sort of fingerprint too. Now, the good news is, because MAC addresses are set by the manufacturer, we don't need to learn how to assign them, but we do need to know what they look like. A MAC address is a 48-bit address made up of a series of hexadecimal digits that looks something like this. Now, a MAC address is made up of two parts. The first group of six digits are known as the Organizationally Unique Identifier, or OUI. And this part identifies the NIC manufacturer. Now, the last six digits are a unique value, again assigned by the NIC manufacturer, to uniquely identify the network interface card. So no two MAC addresses should ever be the same. Now, MAC addresses can be written slightly differently. For example, we see them separated by dots in Linux, or dashes in Windows, or sometimes blocks in the case of Cisco devices. But knowing how to spot MAC addresses, break them down into their OUI and unique value, and also recognize different formats is an essential skill we can apply to both networking and cybersecurity. For example, we can use this information to help identify rogue devices on our network, which we'll cover later on. Now, before I go any further, I need to quickly talk about where MAC addresses fit into the network communication process. Now, when network devices communicate, they must follow a series of steps as set out in the seven layers of the OSI model. And this includes packaging information from the layers above when transmitting, before reaching the final layer, the physical layer, where it is turned into a signal to represent bits. The receiving device then decodes the signal and unpacks the information. Now, we're interested in the layer above the physical layer, the data link layer. Now, when transmitting, this is where the final packaging takes place, resulting in what is known as a frame. Now, each frame must have a destination address to identify the destination device where it's going, and also a source address to identify the source device to reply to. And they're, of course, MAC addresses. The data link layer is also where something called media access control takes place. That is, checking the availability of the media and a whole host of other things. And this is where the MAC address gets its name from, Media Access Control Address. Okay, it's time to head over to the computer lab now, because I'm going to show you how to find the MAC address on both a Linux machine and also a Windows machine. To view a MAC address on a Linux machine, we need to open up a terminal and type ifconfig. And if we take a look underneath our Ethernet adapter, we can see its IP address. And then just below that, there is a set of hexadecimal digits, each separated by colons because this is a Linux machine. And that's our MAC address that we're looking for right there. Now, there's a couple of things to keep in mind. Firstly, if you have IP version 6 enabled, IP version 6 addresses are also written in hexadecimal, so don't get confused there. And also, if you have more than one network adapter in your computer, for example, if you have a Wi-Fi adapter, it will also have its own MAC address. And to view a MAC address on a Windows machine, we need to open up a command prompt. And the command we type is ipconfig/all. And if we take a look underneath our Ethernet adapter, we can see here physical address, and there's our MAC address right there. Notice the pairs of hexadecimal digits are separated by hyphens this time because this is a Windows machine. Now, once we have a MAC address to work with, we can do things like look up the OUI, the Organizationally Unique Identifier, to determine the manufacturer of a NIC. And this can be useful when we're monitoring network traffic to identify things like rogue devices. Now, I'm going to use the Wireshark OUI lookup tool on their website to do this. And I'm going to type in the OUI from our Windows machine that we just looked up, which is 08-00-27, and click Find. And we can see this returns a result of PCS System Technic GmbH. Now, this basically tells me that I'm using a virtual adapter, a MAC address assigned by VirtualBox in my lab. But if I was using a physical device, this is a really good way to identify the NIC manufacturer. And also, most PCs these days have an onboard NIC, which can sometimes help identify the motherboard manufacturer. Now, looking at MAC addresses can be very useful, but it is important to keep in mind that it's also very easy for an attacker to spoof a MAC address. Now, when you're monitoring network traffic, there is a special type of MAC address to be aware of. It's really easy to spot because it will appear as a destination address, and all of the hexadecimal digits will be Fs. And this is known as the broadcast MAC address. Now, when a device sends a broadcast frame, it's sent to every device on the LAN except the incoming port of a switch. And every device will receive the frame and examine it. Broadcasts are extremely important because if a destination device is not known, it's necessary to send the communication to all devices where it will be examined and received by the correct destination device. Well, that brings us to the end of the first session, and I hope you found it helpful. Join me in the next video where we'll learn how network switches use MAC addresses to do their job. We'll also learn how attackers exploit MAC addresses to attack switches. And we'll also cover some mitigations that we can put in place to help prevent attacks. So as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.